Good day, fellas. I hope you are ready for your daily dose of skill. And first of all, sorry for yesterday. I had no powers at all to make a YouTube video or stream, so I apologize for that. But I believe I love you, and I hope you are not mad on me. What we are going to do today, I was looking through the tanks with which I did not play live, and why not to play with a T95? It's very interesting vehicle. You can be, sometimes if you are getting city maps, you can be very lucky. You can play without any brain usage, if I can say so, and you can kill everyone. Probably it's not the right word. The thing is, this vehicle have insanely good armor, but there is a dark side of all this. If you are getting permanently tracked, you are going to cry in the corner. And oh boy, you are not going to enjoy your gaming experience. So that's why I use the toolbox on this vehicle, and that's why I'm using toolbox directive. So let's see how everything is going to look like, and maybe we are going to destroy everyone. By the way, if you are wondering, did I just woke up? Yes, I did. I slept yesterday, I slept like 12 hours. I mean, I was completely out of order, and I was it was probably the, you know, everything needs to be resetted. Computers, phones, skill. I mean, I'm a machine after all, and I need to get resetted too, right? Anyways, what kind of situation do we have right there? It's extremely good map. What we are going to do, we will go in front. T95 video coming. T95 video coming. Damn it. Shh. I'm undercover. that was good one, fellas. That's it. I think we need to change the tank. Well, at least I tried to surprise you. Hashtag never lucky. Okay, guys. I have a feeling, look what our team is doing. Very, very interesting stuff. So our team decided to go over there. Even heavy tanks are going over there. Very interesting stuff. Now, what do I need to figure out? Do I want to push very aggressively right there, or I don't want to push? I kind of want to go through a lot through the middle. The thing is, they do not have heavy tanks too. I mean, yeah, BK is a heavy tank, and yes, it's strong heavy tank, but with a T95, I will simply say, and I will eat him. Okay, guys, this is quite risky stuff, but I am up to take this risk, okay? I hope I won't regret this, maybe I will, but we are going aggressively. I mean, we are playing with a Doom Turtle. What could go wrong with it? I want to reach this position over there. And from this position, there is a chance I will spot Arta or whatever is sitting right there. Or maybe punish someone in the corner here. You never know. So let's go for it. Slowly but surely on the 15 kilometers per hour. Pir. And we can't see shit. Actually, we can see shit. Look at this beauty. Beep. I don't know how about you, but I love burning Progetto's smell in the morning. Mmm. It's just... music to my nose. I tried, okay? Look. There is a Tiger 2. Yeah. Tiger 2. You are the winner. How Tiger managed to penetrate me? This is impressive, fellas. And this is impressive. Tiger penetrated us, and Wafflecock penetrated us. Wafflecock is sitting somewhere over there, probably here. I lost quite some unnecessary hit points right there, but hey, what can you do? I have high explosives loaded, and now I will try to blind fire this Wafflecock. Maybe that will work in our favor, right? I hope so. I'm pretending I can't see him and I'm pretending I'm semi-special. So maybe this guy will peek once again, but apparently it's not going to be the case. Shame. Okay. Plan B. Plan B is looking like this. We are going like this. We will smack this tiger once again. Which is interesting. I mean, look. Majority of our guys died right here, which is very, very sad thing, but once again, not much what we can do about that. They simply died, right? Now we need to figure out what is the right way for us to make pressure and to kill the enemies without getting killed ourselves. Oh, sounds so damn easy skill. I know, it is easy. Okay, unfortunately this is GG. We are already getting flanked from the all sides and stuff, so not much what we can do right here. And this Jack Tiger have very, very nice DPM, but we can punish him right here. I see that too, don't worry. I see this too. Okay, maybe if we are going to clear this side, maybe it's not going to be that bad. Lorraine is begging for help. I wish I would be able to help this guy. Okay, maybe I could. Sorry, man. That's what I can say for this guy. Unfortunate. Okay, Sue one hander through the field, trollolo. Sue is going to the garage. Excellent. Now I'm going to have high explosives for the Mr. Roo. Oh. I try to block him and to not let him to flank me, but it is how it is. Okay, guys. Speaking about the tanks like the T95, right? What is happening right here? What is happening in that kind of situations? Unfortunately, but when you actually have no team, or when enemy team is way better than your team is, flexibility of this tank is very, very small, right? And although we tried to do everything what we could right here, unfortunately we did not manage to win this battle, and not much what we can change right here. If you would pay attention what is the score of this game, what we did and what our team did, I believe that would be quite clear. It was not, let's say like that, it was not the best play from our side, but not the worst play either way. Well, what can you do? Okay, let's go for other couple of battles with a T95. I hope in one of those games we are going to flex on enemies. I hope we are going to send them to the garage, and then I can say yes, Doom Turtle. I hope so. Yeah, probably reality is going to be a bit different. Skill will get banged in the by the light tanks or by the budget, which is saying bad tortoise, a bad T95, bad Doom Turtle. Probably that's what is going to be, but we'll see. Okay, right here in this map, there is only one way which I think is wise with this vehicle. I don't want to go 1-2 line, I don't want to snipe, I want to go into the heavy line. Even though, you know, heavy light is quite interesting situation, because you can't push like this. Well, you can, but there is a big chance you will lose a lot of hit points while going in this way, and so on, so on. But fellas, fingers crossed, hopefully, it's not going to happen, and maybe we are going to have a big fight over there against billion of the enemy forces, and we are going to kill them all. We'll see. Fingers crossed. Let's hope for the best, boys. And by the way, guys, if you grinded the E3 line, right, what do you think about the T95? Do you like it? Do you hate it? Do you think it's okay? Do you think it's overpowered? I'm quite curious about your opinion. Funny fact, I like T95 more than I like E3, tier 10. Once again, maybe it's only me, but T95 armor for some reason is working way better. Although I cannot say the armor of the E3 is trash by any means, But I feel like armor on the T95 as a tier 9 with a tier 9 matchmaking is just way better. I mean, imagine, you are finding the poor Tiger. Tiger is dying in literally 14 seconds, because first shot after that you are shooting second time and he is just dead like this. Our Viper is going to get killed right there. Poor Viper. Are you ready for this? Fellas, are you ready for this? Because I know where the scout is. How do I know that I'm hacker? If we would hit this guy in the face, that would be so damn beautiful. So damn beautiful. I should be spotted. Now for sure. I think that was a direct hit. I want to believe that was a direct hit, fellas. What do you think? I will go for another blind shot right here. Maybe we are going to eliminate this guy from the game in this way, but you know. I'm just trying, let's say like that. Oh. So I think he effed off. After the first shot. I see. I need to help my team over there. This is very, very important stuff. So, what we are going to do, we are piri-piri trying to turn around. And now we are going to help the heavy line. This battle don't really have any potential whatsoever. Why this game don't have any potential? Enemy team is simply way too weak. And if the enemy team have a weak team, well, this is the problem, you know? It's not very good, let's say like that. The potential of this battle is very, very, very low. And I wish to say something different, but I simply can't. By the way, Xor with a 3 hit points. Maybe it's only me, but I think I penetrated him with a blind shot with a high explosives. Now you know how to counter the light which is sitting right there and when you are crossing there with a heavy tank, right? Okay, T95 right there, he will try to snipe my cupola and it's completely understandable, he doesn't have anything better to do. And look, this is the problem with the tanks like this, at least in my opinion, right? When battles are finishing like this, in literally 4 minutes, there is a chance you are not even going to be in position in time. And although I love the T95 with all my heart, when enemy team is sucking too much, or let's say like that, when you are not putting enough aggression, because I want to believe I did not put enough aggression right here, plus this shot was bad, the other shot was RNG, but you know, not much what I can do about that. It is World of Tanks in 2019, as wrong as it sounds, and yeah, I would love to bang them all with a big smile on my face, but unfortunately enemy team is dying before I have opportunity to bang them, which is sad, but hey, what can you do? Shot into the Jack Tiger right there. Oh my bananas from Banana Land. It's not my David a Doom Turtle, guys. It is not my David a Doom Turtle. That's quite sad. But hey, this is the live gameplay, fellas. Not all the time you can be the hero of the day. And not all the time you can get yourself curva flowers, if we can say so. I wish to say something different, but I definitely can't. Can we hit this guy once, please? Thank you. That's beautiful. Okay, so maybe it's not that bad. Now look, I hope we have that blind shot on that light tank when I shot him with high explosives. I hope so. Obviously, reality could be different. I could miss that. But hey, fingers crossed. Let's see. Did we manage to hit that light tank in the standard bush with a T95? Although, if I would come to the heavy line earlier, more likely my score would be better just by ignoring that light, but it is how it is. Not much what we can change right there. And yep, Fellas, as you can see, what we managed to do right there, we managed to blind fire the light tank with a high explosive 900 in the face and couple of critical hits. I believe this light tank was not very, very happy, but he managed to spot 2,800 anyway, so maybe it's not that bad. So this is the score, only 3000 damage, pretty much non-assisting damage, okay, 500 assisting damage. Not the battles for which I am aiming for, come on. The third battle is going to be the charm. In the third game, we are going to be the hero of the days. The score will finish 15-2 and I will get gangbanged by the 13 guys. But this is the plan, this is the prediction. Fingers crossed, let's hope it's not going to be the case. Wow. Wow. Okay. Wow. Look. This is... I don't even know what the flying F I supposed to say. Okay. This is a tier 7 battle. You know what you can do with a tier 7s with a T95? So... The plan is very, very simple. We are going through the 1-2 line and I believe we are going to be very aggressive right there. I think I want to cross like this. Then I want to check out who is playing over there. And after that, I think I might go like this and make a pressure like this eventually. This could be a possibility. But first of all, I need to cross like this. Cross your fingers for me, fellas, and let's hope for the best. This is the plan. Okay, so this is a warming up for me. Those games is the first battles. After this, I am going to do the Tech 3 showcase, as I promised for the 705A. But I can tell you that my brain is warming up. All I need to do, I need to have a morning coffee. Skill is talking about the morning at 2 p.m. Like I said, morning games when you are just waking up and so on, right, fellas? Okay, good. So like I said, plan is simple. Let's see, can we have a perfect execution for this game? I hope so. I have a feeling they might have a lot of bushwankers over there, right? This is the feeling which I have. I cannot turn to this guy. But I need to. Russia. Oh. Unfortunately, I did not manage to punish this guy for his mistake right there because I went on the stone right there. But not much what I can do about that. Look how fast repairs is working on this vehicle. That's nuts. Hi. Look, the tier 7 or the same object, they can't do shit for me. I am feeling so damn well, it's crazy how well I am feeling right here. And although I am in the middle of the field, they still can't do too many things for me, which is just beautiful. Now we are hitting this guy into his balls and now I'm just pushing in front because I am brave, okay? He missed his shot and I'm still getting hit by the Arta and by the T-34-100. But to be completely honest with you, I don't really care about that. I'm just going in front. Now look, this guy might peek right there very, very soon and I don't really care. I just want to make a pressure, he peeked, I'm trying to shoot him, too bad I did not manage to eliminate him from the game because he is a big pain in the ass. And this is the T95 game about I am talking, which I am talking about. You have literally zero Fs given and you are pushing straight into the enemies without any problems whatsoever. Let's say like that. This is the game which I am talking about, right? Beautiful. So now our first things is done. Can we say it is over for us and we can we won this battle already? Not yet, but soon we will say that. Okay, wait a second. I'm trying to build a better angle for that T-34-100. And as you can see, enemies are shooting high explosives from here. But I can't blame them. Hey. Don't do that. I'm fine, mate. This guy just wanted to help for me, but thanks. Very nice. What we are going to do now, we are going to try to craft the angle for that Starva. We have angle for Starva, we are taking our time to aim, and we are hitting him for 700 in the face. I mean, this battle is pretty much perfect. This battle is perfect, because enemies guys simply can't do anything for us, and we can claim their life pretty much for free. For example, this Su with a high explosive sitting in the back, he is taking 666 from the devil himself, which is called the T95, and that's it, finito. I mean, did enemies had a chance in this kind of situation? No, they didn't. And this is the best battle so far with this vehicle today, for sure. That was auto-aim, by the way, because there was plenty of obstacles in front, right? The thing is, when plus two matchmaking is looking like this, when you are getting a map where you can pretty much flex on the enemies without any questions asked and so on, you are the king of the hill, you are the king of the world, and that's why plus two matchmaking sucks. Do you think it's, for me, it is interesting to play in the matchup like this? Oh yes. No, it's not, okay? No, it's not interesting, because the... you are pretty much bullying the lower tiers, and you are saying who is my bitch for every single of them. And if you are not getting flying yet, for example, with this vehicle, it's GG for the enemies. And you know what? That's kind of good, because I'm speaking that's good not about matchmaking, but about this battle we had. Because I managed to show you what the T95 is all about. And our T29, the hero of the day. Yes, T95. What's up, man? Good. Anyways, fellas, that was your daily dose of skill. I'm sorry, I'm semi-sleepy. Once again, I apologize for not having the video yesterday. I was simply completely out of order, and I was definitely... I needed to restart my brain and everything. Now we are coming back to the normal YouTube content, and you know, by not uploading for one day, it is not the end of the world, right? Anyways, fellas, wait before finishing, we need to flex right here. Ta-da! What we did in this battle, we went straight forward by saying, and we killed them all. Why so? Only one art in the game, nothing who could stop us, minus too much making in our favor, we went in front, we killed them all. This is what the T95 is all about. And I know it looks weird, I am using the toolbox, because I believe ventilation would be just fine, but I am doing this to not get flanked that easily, and it's working fine, so why to change something, right? Thank you so much for watching, fellas. That was your daily dose of skill, and tomorrow's video is going to be the Object 705A Tech 3 showcase, couple of games each with a tier 8, tier 9, and tier 10. Right there, maybe 3 games each, maybe 2 games each, we'll see how the things will go and how battles will go. I want to show how to play with those vehicles and why I don't like them. Anyways, that was your daily dose of skill. See you tomorrow. It was a pleasure for me to play with a Doom Turtle. Battles was not very, very good, but endgame was just great. Thank you, see you next time. Skill is out. Peace.